Today, we celebrate Good Shepherd Sunday and Vocation Sunday. We see our Lord described as the cornerstone on which the church is built, the big brother who always watches out for us, and the Good Shepherd who not only was willing to lay his life down for us, but did. This Sunday, also the Vocation Sunday, let us pray for the many and good vocations to continue the work of the Shepherd.
This Mass is offered as a thanksgiving for all the favors received by John Alexis' family, Bellarmine's family, Neil Binney, and Mary Lyon Alexander and Nick Nagarjuna family. And this Mass is also offered for the good health of Judith Louis and for good health of Manasseh family and for protection and good health of Eric, Jackie, Joel, Daniel, Edmonds and for good health of Jacinta Mal. Let's pray for the repose of the souls of Marie Eric, Sheila Edmonds, Harry Vasant, James Manasseh, deceased members of Sohn's and Edmonds families, deceased members of Pallavaram fraternity, Daisy Paul, Dulce Fulinfa, Cedric Claiborne, Mr. and Mrs. Gregory Fernando, John Maria, Celine Selvi, Irudayam Paul Raj, Dalton, and V. E. Varghese, whose 13th death anniversary is observed today. Let us pray God may grant them all eternal rest. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
The fourth Sunday of Easter is celebrated as the Good Shepherd Sunday. As we celebrate the Good Shepherd Sunday, each one of us is given a dual role to play in the church. One, that of a shepherd. We are supposed to lead others into the right path. We are supposed to guard others from dangers. The second role is to be a good sheep. We are supposed to hear the voice of the Good Shepherd and to follow the path that he shows. Let us examine and see whether we have been a good shepherd and good sheep. If we have failed in our duties as a good shepherd and good sheep, let us ask the Lord pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory in the highest, glory.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Shepherd has entrusted his sheep to Peter and the apostles without relinquishing them so that their pastoral needs can continue to be met.
There is no other name by which we must be saved. The first reading. A reading from the Acts, chapter 4, verses 8 to 12. In those days, Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, "Rulers of the people and elders, if we are being examined today concerning a good deed done to a crippled man, by what means this man has been healed? Let it be known to all of you and to all the people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, by him this man is standing before you well. This Jesus is the stone that was rejected by you, the builders which has become the cornerstone. And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm, our response will be, "The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone." Give praise to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes. Our response?
The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone.
I will thank you, for you have answered, and you are my Savior. The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord, has this been done a marvel in our eyes? Our response?
The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. You are my God, I praise you. My God, I exalt you. Give praise to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Our response?
The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone.
In today's second reading, we're reminded that our Lord laid down his life so that we could become not only his property, but his adopted brothers and sisters.
The second reading, we shall see God as he is. A reading from the first letter of St. John, chapter 3, verses 1 to 2. Beloved, see what kind of love the Father has given to us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. The reason why the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now, and what we will be has not yet appeared. But we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel acclamation. Shepherd, says the Lord, I know my own, and my own know me.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He who is a hired hand and not a shepherd, who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees, and the wolf snatches them and scatters them. He flees because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep, and I have other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A priest instructed a sacristan to write the responsorial psalm on the whiteboard before the Mass. And that day, the response to the responsorial psalm was, The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. And the board was small, and the response was long. So the priest instructed the sacristan, just write, the Lord is my shepherd, that's enough. The priest was busy and he did not bother to check what the boy had written. When the part of the Mass where the responsorial psalm had to be repeated came, the priest was shocked, at the same time amused, because he heard the people say, the Lord is my shepherd, that is enough. My dear friends, today the church celebrates the Good Shepherd Sunday. Even though it was a mistake by the sacristan, this word today fits perfectly. The Lord is my shepherd, that's enough for me. The title shepherd in the Old Testament refers primarily to God, who shepherds his flock. This is brought out in Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd. Here God is portrayed as a faithful and good shepherd who leads the flock into well-being and who keeps them safe from every danger. In the Old Testament, kings as God's anointed deputies were also referred to as shepherds. But some of them only got the title and not the qualities of a shepherd. Instead of feeding the sheep entrusted to their care, they fed on them. On account of their infidelity, God made this promise to his people that he himself will be their shepherd. We read this in Ezekiel chapter 34, verses 15 and 16. This promise of God that he will be the shepherd was fulfilled in Jesus, who declared himself, I am the good shepherd. And John 10:10 we read, I came that they may have life and have it abundantly. And before Jesus left the world, he commissioned Peter to feed his lambs and to tend his sheep. The work of shepherding God's flock is an ongoing task that is entrusted to the whole church with Peter as its head. As today we celebrate the Good Shepherd Sunday, we need to ask ourselves two important questions. One, am I a faithful member of God's flock? Only those sheep who follow the guidance of the shepherd could ever hope to arrive at the green pastures or be safe from the dangerous wolves. Second question, how could I participate more closely in the work of shepherding God's flock? Not only bishops and priests, but also Sunday school teachers, ushers, readers, members of the choir, all participate in various forms of shepherding God's flock. How can I be a better shepherd in my own state, reaching out with understanding and compassion to the weak and misguided dropouts of the church and society, so that through me they may hear the loving voice of Jesus, the Good Shepherd? Am I a good sheep? Am I a good shepherd? As we celebrate the Good Shepherd Sunday today, the church invites us to celebrate the World Day of Prayer for Vocations. We are aware that the months of April and May are crucial for young men and women to chalk out their future plans in terms of their further studies, job, life partner, etc. We are also aware that some of these young men and women wish to follow the call of God to serve the people as religious and priests. We bring all the young men and women, especially during this pandemic, to the loving embrace of God so that they can be guided well in their decision-making process. The Lord is my shepherd, that is enough. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, filled with Paschal joy, let us pray more earnestly to God that he who graciously listened to the prayers and supplications of his beloved Son may now be pleased to look upon us in our lowliness.
Your response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that as shepherds of the flock of Christ, they may guide and protect them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For unity among Christians, that the Church, which remained united for so many centuries, but has experienced division for the last 500 years, that every effort may be made to bring about unity among churches, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the universal Church, that all members of the Church may remain faithful to the teachings of Jesus and may be committed to spread it far and wide, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved nation and the great majority of Indians who practice Hinduism, that they may be blessed for the tolerance and welcome they show towards people of other faiths, among whom also those who practice the Christian faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, that inspired by the example of Jesus, who died for his people, we too may die to our selfishness and narrow-mindedness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please pray for your local and community needs.
Let's pray for those affected by COVID-19 and those who are taking treatment in the hospitals, and those who are kept in isolation at home or in the hospitals. Let's pray that God's all-embracing love may cure them, may give them good health. Let's pray as Good Shepherd. God, may guard us from this pandemic. Let's pray for all those who work tirelessly to regain the health of those affected by COVID-19. Let's pray for our brothers and sisters who are not able to participate in this Holy Eucharist directly. O God, who know that our life in this present age is subject to suffering and need, hear the desires of those who cry to you and receive the prayers of those who believe in you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy. Every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our love. Lord Jesus.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, and all the clergy, the religious, and the faithful. Remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep, the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and found by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, the Good Shepherd, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
prepared to Saint Joseph. Hail, guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to you God entrusted his only Son. In you Mary placed her trust. With you Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a Father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen. A prayer vocation. O Jesus, our good shepherd, bless all our parishes with numerous priests, deacons, men and women in religious life, consecrated laity and missionaries, according to the needs of the entire world, which you love and wish to save. We especially entrust our parish community to you. Grant us the spirit of the first Christians, so that we may be a cenacle of prayer in loving acceptance of the Holy Spirit and his gifts. Assist our pastors and all who live a consecrated life. Guide the steps of those who have responded generously to your call and are preparing to receive holy orders or to profess the evangelical counsel. Look with love on so many well-disposed young people and call them to follow you. Help them to understand that in you alone can they attain to complete fulfillment. To this end, we call on the most powerful intercession of Mary, Mother and model of all vocations. We beseech you to sustain our faith with the certainty that the Father will grant what you have commanded us to ask. Amen.
I wish you all to be good shepherds, to be responsible, and good sheep, to be obedient always. Individually or collectively as a family, today try to read and pray meditatively Psalm 23, and receive peace, consolation, and strength. Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
As I bow my head in prayer to sacrament most holy. O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.